Chris Berry, MBE, has recently received his award for contribution in education in Sierra Leone, and he is with me. Welcome, Chris.
Hi, Al.
Do I have to curtsy or not just...
Don't do any curtsying.
Okay. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
That's very impressive.
Yeah.
And I'd be delighted if you could tell us a little bit about your work. I know that you've just received the award.
Yeah.
And you've been to Sierra Leone on a couple of different occasions. Yeah. But most recently, you worked there just after the whole Ebola issue was going on there, yeah. Which was, well, very brave of you to
Thank
do.
You.
So maybe tell me first, who do you work with, and in a nutshell, what do you do?
So I work for the Department for International Development. So that's the bit of the UK government that does aid to poorer countries. And I'm an education advisor, and I've been working there for about 17 years now.
Right.
Yeah.
And so education advisor means what? Kind of putting programs in place, advising to the government?
Yeah, so I work both, actually, working in countries. So I've worked in Sierra Leone, I've also worked in Ethiopia, I've worked in Tanzania. So working with those governments to help them to improve their education systems. So that's both some advice and some finance as well.
Okay. Yeah. And the MBE, let's have a look at the medal
shall
we?
So there's
show it to the camera.
There's the MBE.
And you got it from Prince William.
I got it from Prince William himself, yes, in Buckingham Palace. It was very,
nice.
Very
did
grand.
Did you have to kneel? Or?
I did have to do a bit of bowing. There's no sword involved.
Right.
It's an
not
MBE.
Yet, that's the next one.
I have to do, you have to bow and you have to, you get 30 seconds with him where he asks what you got it for and to tell you a little bit like this, but I've got longer today. So
yeah, you're very privileged to have
I'm very privileged to have you, exactly, yeah.
So that was for your contribution in Sierra Leone under difficult circumstances.
Yeah.
Let's start at the beginning. You went there first in 1983, didn't you,
as a
young man, and that was your first time abroad, really.
Yeah, the first time I'd ever been on an aeroplane, Yael. I flew to Sierra Leone, to Freetown. I was 23, and I worked for voluntary service overseas then, and I went to work as a teacher of English in a place called Yonibana, which is in the north of the country, and I spent 3 years there. And then I actually went back again that same, just afterwards, and I worked for another 2 years in Sierra. So I was about there for about 5 years in Sierra Leone the 1980s. Yeah.
So you got a very good knowledge of the place, obviously.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then came the dreadful period a few years ago of the Ebola, and the government or your workplace really asked for volunteers to go there.
Yeah.
Why did you volunteer? Were you not scared? Did you not think, well, actually, maybe that's too much?
So I've got a family, so obviously you always think about your family, but I just felt like I hadn't been back since I left in 1989. I'd kept in touch with people there, and I'd very much been following what was going on, but I hadn't been back, and I thought, well, this is a real chance to contribute again. So that was my main motivation, was to go and make a contribution. This was just as Ebola was ending. So the government was trying to work with Sierra Leone to help them to rebuild.
Because schools were closed.
Schools had been closed for a whole year. And then there were real risks as children went back to school of infection. So there were still pockets of Ebola around. Very important with Ebola to hand wash is one of the key things to prevent the spread of it. So making sure that every school in the country, and there's about 1.2 million kids were going back to school. Every school in the country had access to water and hand washing. And in Sierra Leone,
which of course to us is it's taken for granted, but not at all.
There's lots of schools with no water, there's no facilities for washing. So this is a big deal in Sierra Leone to make sure that those things were in place. And then also some support for the children going back, psychosocial support.
Because a lot of them will have lost family members.
Exactly. A lot of orphans as a result of Ebola. And many of them were going back to school, but they needed support to do that. And even if you hadn't lost a family member, most children had seen some dreadful thing, and teachers actually, some dreadful things.
Right.
It was a very difficult time.
Right. So input to education is not just kind of educational programs to do with learning, but it's obviously a holistic approach. It's the sanitation, it's the water, it's perhaps counselling.
No, exactly, yeah.
Show us the medal, Veribola, will you? I know you don't want to be Mr. Medalman, but this is...
So this is the other medal, Yael, that I got, which was for the Ebola, the time I spent post-Ebola, yeah. Thank you.
Right. Chris, thank you so much for coming and sharing this experience with us.
Thank you,
And
Yael.
Congratulations
thank
again.
Thank you. Yeah, thanks very much.